Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you what I use for my pet portraits. I'm going to start out by showing you which color pencil brands I use. I mostly use this one, Faber-Castell Polychromos. I use it since 4 years ago and I really love it and I wouldn't change it. It is very they have a lot of vibrant colors, they blend good and yeah, they work really well. I also use this white pencil from Carandash. From this brand I only use this the white color because it works very good with my Faber-Castell Polychromos, and I use it to blend them and to burnish the color into the paper or to make it lighter. So I really love the combination between those two. And yeah, this is what I mainly use for my pet portraits. I also use mechanical pencils. I use this one from Pentel, 0.7 millimeters, and this one from Staedtler, 0.3 millimeters. I mostly use this one 0.7 millimeters for my for medium size fur, and this one 0.3 millimeters for my fine lines or like really thin fur and like around the eyes, or if I can't reach an area with my pencil, I use this one. And I'm going to show the difference. This is the thin one. And this is the thick one, the 0.7 millimeters. You can see the difference. And also if I create fur, look how thin the fur looks with this one and how it looks with the 0.7 millimeters one. Yeah, you can see the difference. Next, I'm going to show you which pencil extenders I use. I use three types, these three. I use this one from Amazon. I don't know the brand because I have it since a long time ago. I also use this one from Derwent. And I also use this one, also I don't remember the brand. I also got it from Amazon. And I'm going to show you what I like and I don't like about them and what I use them for. This one, I use this when the pencil is really really small and I can't hold it in my hand or in between my fingers. It works really well because I just need to put it a bit in and after move it up. And I like it because it's very light and it's very it does the job very good. But I don't like it because what I don't like about it is that here where I hold it with my fingers, it is made out of metal, and sometimes after a long time of drawing it really hurts my finger here because it is metal here, and I also this part really pushes in my skin and it hurts me sometimes, so I'm trying to avoid using it for too long. This one, I use this one when my pencils are like this size, because if the pencil is smaller than this, I really don't like using it. And I put it in a pencil extender and I just put it like this, and after bit by bit until it's done using it. And I also, sorry, and I don't like about this one is that it's very heavy, and if I try to make very light, like a very light fur, being very heavy sometimes makes my fingers press too hard and I can't ruin my fine fur, or my by pressing too hard ruining my the thing for I'm trying to achieve. And also this one, I also this is my favorite because it is very light and it holds the pencil very good. And also here it's very handy for my finger, it doesn't hurt. And it's very nice to use. I normally use this one also when the pencils are like around this side. This side, sorry. It's very nice. It's a bit more expensive, but it works also very good. Next, I am going to show you what I use for blending sometimes. I use two brushes and more blending stamps, more sizes, but I just chose this small one for now, for this video. This one, I am using it since a long time ago. It is a very cheap makeup brush. You can find those everywhere, like makeup stores or, yeah, like $1 store. And it has two sides, a small and a wider side. And I normally use it to make my like the graphite or the color look smoother and to blend. For example, if I'm using if I think I'm trying to I'm starting out by using light pressure, and my goal will be to try to achieve a smooth look and to get rid of those harsh lines. I start out just by applying light pressure and trying to get rid of the pencil marks as more as possible. I'm making circular moves. Yeah, and literally all you have to do is just apply light pressure and circular movements and trying to get rid of the pencil marks and achieving a smooth look. Like, and sometimes if I want to make the middle area darker, I just go back with my pencil and I also blend sometimes around it a bit. And just keep continuing doing this until it looks how I want. I also use another makeup brush, a very small one. I cut it a bit. I use this one for really small areas, and I do the same. I'm tr using it by applying light pressure and circular movements, and just trying to get rid of the pencil strokes or the harshness of the pencil. So you can see. Starts to get very smooth. And I also use this, the blending stamps. For example, I use it for like as a base layer or to try to cover an area as fast as possible. For example, this is the chin of the dog. Here's the mouth, yeah, the nose, the eyes. All I have to do is just applying light pressure until I reach the tone I want, and after come back with my pencil and creating the fur by using light pressure. And if I want like more a darker fur, I just press harder. If you noticed, but if you noticed, you can see I have at all my pencil at the end of all my pencils and pencil extenders. This thing here, it's a moldable eraser, and I do that because it saves me a lot of time. Because I just, if I'm, for example, if I'm drawing fur and I want to erase it, I don't have to look everywhere around my desk. I just turn my pencil and erase it. I've never seen this at other artists. I got the idea just by trying to make my to save more time and make my work faster. And I was thinking, what can I do? And I was thinking maybe what can I add on at the end of my pencil, like to make it to save more time. And I added this moldable eraser. It feels like I have a two-sided pencil. It saved me a lot of time. I also use this Mono Zero Tombow eraser. I love this one. I keep dropping it, sorry. I use this one. I bought this one. I started using it, I think, 2 years ago, and I love it. I mostly use it for small areas, to erase small areas, like, for example, around the eye, or sometimes even to create like highlights on the fur. But mostly I use it in the eye, for example. I'm going to make something which looks, try to look like the eye. And I'm using this one to make highlights, but not like very like white highlights. Some are between, a bit grayish. This also makes the eye looks more natural and realistic. I just apply like a very light pressure. As you can see, it's not white, it's a bit grayish. Only because when you're drawing eyes, you need to make more types of shading and highlights. For example, like white highlights, medium highlights, or very very discrete highlights, because those make the eye look very realistic and it can totally change the drawing. And yeah, I really recommend this one. It is not very cheap, but it's very good quality and it does work. And it also comes with refillers, and after you can buy them separately. You just need to put it in. It's very easy to change. Yeah, and I really recommend it. Next, I'm going to show you another material I use. It is a whiting pen. I use it every drawing. And I don't think I could draw without it. I think I only use it when I'm drawing eyes to make like a white highlight. For example, I'm going to try here, look, just by making one point, look how much difference it makes, and it brings the drawing to life. And I really recommend it. I also use it sometimes in the details, for example, of if I have a drawing and I need to make like I have a pet portrait and I need to draw a dog, and the dog has a collar. I'm using it in the collar to make highlights. Or for example, if I need to make a drawing of a horse, I'm making highlights in the halter of the horse. Or literally just very white details. Also, I use this slice tool. I started using it, this one, this brand of knives, around 1 month ago, and I really love them. I saw them on internet, on Instagram or on Facebook or YouTube videos of other artists, and I was really curious to try it, and I ordered one, and I really fell in love with it. It is basically a ceramic knife. This one has a very small and precise tip. And I use it to create fur, and I'm going to create highlights in the fur. It was in two pieces, but by mistake I broke it. It was like this. It's like this. From Faber-Castell Polychromas. It's very nice, I love it, and I totally recommend it. I also use this big brush to clean my paper and to remove some of the leftovers of the eraser off of the pencil or of the pencil. It is very smooth, you barely can feel it on your hand. It's very large and yeah, very wide, and you can clean very fast, big areas and very fast, and it doesn't leave any marks. And I totally recommend it. It's from Da Vinci. Yeah, and I really love it. I use it all the time with every drawing. Now I'm going to show you which paper I use. I use this one. Sorry. It's Winsor & Newton drawing and sketching paper. Bristol board, extra smooth surface. It has a very smooth texture. I mean, it doesn't have a texture at all. It is very smooth and I love it. It works very good with my Faber-Castell Polychromos pencils. And I have it in two sizes, A4 and A5. I'm going to, yeah, A4 and A5. I really love it. I love smooth surfaced paper. I think it makes my drawing look more realistic, and I also work easier on them, and my pencil, yeah, makes my pencil slide easier, and I feel more comfortable working on a smooth surface. Before, I used to draw on a very textured cold press paper, and you could see the texture, and you had to burnish the color a lot, and I didn't like it because it took me a lot of time, and I switched to hot press paper, this one. And I really love it, and I recommend it. I bought those from Amazon, and they're really nice. Now I'm going to show you what I use to make my sketches. I use this light pad. I took it from Amazon. It is very nice. It saves me a lot of time. And in the beginning, some people accuse me of, like not being a real artist, big artist, because I'm using a light pad to sketch. They think you normally should be able to sketch, to freehand sketch. But I think it doesn't matter as long as the final result is amazing and realistic. It doesn't matter how you start out, because in the end, people are going to see the end result and not the sketch you made in the beginning. So you don't have to be afraid of what people say. You just need to use what makes your job easier. I also used to use the grid method. And it is literally just drawing squares on your reference photo and on your paper. And trying to follow the squares from the reference photo and redo them on your paper. And I think this is all. Those materials, I use them almost in every drawing. I couldn't work without them. I just found them by trying what works for me and what doesn't work for me. And I kept the ones who made my job easier. And I removed the ones that I didn't like or they didn't work for me. And I think this is the end. Thank you for watching. And please let me know what you think in the comments below. And I hope you really enjoyed it. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Bye.